YouTube, welcome to Cafe No Man. Welcome to our reaction to Blue. We are going to react to the song One Love. Let's get started.
This song was pretty popular back then. Start of this century, I think.
Yeah.
Somewhere around 2005 to 2010, probably. This song must have been very popular in India, at least.
Yeah.
So, I have heard this song in the past, but it's been ages since I've heard it. Today, it's like possibly 10 years, 15 years since I've heard this song. Wow, long time.
The worst part of it is, I didn't even know it was made by Blue. I didn't know the artist. We always heard it somewhere or the other just playing. Somebody or the other playing. And didn't bother knowing about the artist.
Yeah, in fact, I don't think I've ever heard another song by Blue. This artist called Blue.
Me too.
Yeah, it's kind of thought-provoking, though pretty repetitive, most of it. It's thought-provoking for sure. One love is all we need. I'm not going to give up, I'm not going to give in. I'm in two minds what it's about, whether it's someone who's not willing to give up on love, or is it about loyalty to one's community, to one's race, to one's nation. I'm not sure if it's either of those or both or neither. Mm-hmm. Not sure. Maybe Kirti will help.
I think there was enough discussion even when we used to listen to it during the college days. Is it a love song? Because most young people played it like a love song. And a lot of people who, you know, liked the lyrics of it, they would say, this is not a love song. Why are you playing it? So there was a lot of debate about it. There used to be arguments about it. But I think it's about love at large. It's about love. It's about love for your nation, love for your country, love for your society, love for love of your life, everything. And the spirit of not giving up on, you know, things that matter to you. Things that you can actually, you know, take forward and make things better along with it. So it's about that spirit of not giving up and sticking with what you think is right. That is what the song essentially should have been. A lot of people said, you know, some people say it's about the love for the motherland and nothing to do with romantic love or, you know, relationship love, but it's got love in the center of it. It's whichever you can, it's open to interpretations. You can decide which love you are going to.
Yeah, the lines definitely mention one love for the city streets, one love for the hip hop beats,
yeah, everything for music, for
my mother's pride,
yeah.
Or mother's, yeah, pride or something. Yeah. So it has definitely a lot to do with the nation, community, location, etc., wherever you live, you know, the pride and loyalty to belonging to that particular place. So definitely that seems to be one part of it. The chorus is the part that confuses me. I don't want to give up. I don't want to give in. And then love me, love me, love me towards the end.
Yeah.
That bridge kind of thing, or a different direction when the song took a different direction before coming back to the hook. That hook is pretty catchy.
I like the music too. Everything about this song, they made it, you know, certain things just click and it just comes right with the sound and everything. And this is one of those songs. One Love, I think people know the tune by itself. The moment it plays, people know how it's going to go. So things came out pretty well for the song.
Yeah, I could be mistaken, but One Love is possibly also a one-hit wonder for Blue.
Should be, I think.
Because
yeah.
I don't know if they have any other song, or maybe, actually I don't know much about Blue itself. So it would be interesting to see the kind of people that come to watch this reaction video.
Yeah.
Of course, at most times it's the label workers and a lot of manipulation in the comments, which is now pretty well known by most YouTubers and most people.
Yeah, we don't get the right thing.
I think it would be, with my experience of being on YouTube for so many years, and being a YouTuber or a creator of videos for four years, it would be safe to say that less than 5% of YouTube comments are real. When I say real, I don't mean that they are done by robots or something. They are real people making them, but real people as in someone who really came to watch this reaction video because they heard this song, they liked this song. I think the ones who comment, less than 5% of them are real. Real commenters. So it's sad. YouTube doesn't want to address this problem, I think. They're more interested in making money. Any business at that side of the world is. So ethics and other things go down the drain.
It exists for money, so yeah.
Yeah. So it definitely compromises the quality of our channel, Enoma, where we love quality interaction, but it never comes our way, or a very small percentage. Anyway, that's it for this one.
One Love or not, we would need some love, at least some genuine love from real people and YouTube to begin with, because it's confusing all the time. It is confusing. There is no real feedback. There is nothing real that I feel. I don't know.
It's all scripted. It's all fake. It's all manipulated. That's sad. It's really, really sad.
Yeah. Need more love.
Kind of how the White House operates. Yeah. That's it for this one. Thank you.